Todoist have had a busy couple of weeks, and in today's video I wanted to run over their brand new feature Workspaces that allows teams to start connecting their Todoist and collaborating on projects. We're going to see whether it's right for you and your team, how it works, and also later in the video discuss more of their recent updates that span across their personal and calendar abilities that we'll discuss in how that's going to shape the future of Todoist. So here in front of me, we have the Todoist team workspaces, and I've got it running on my account, and I'm actually using it as a way to break down some of my tasks. Now, really interestingly, you can create a workspace for free. I thought this was going to be completely locked, but with the free workspace, you're actually limited to, I believe, 5 projects per one. I'll get a breakdown on the screen now. But this is what it looks like. I'm actually on the business plan, which I think is priced at $6 per month, just for demonstration purposes. But you can see that you get a few things here. You can search across all of the lists of projects that you are working on. And here you can also see what active projects and archived projects you have. And this is particularly good because if you want to bring a project back from it being demolished, then you can bring it back from there. And you can also see what ones you're joined and what projects you're not part of as more team members come on. Now here, one thing you can do is actually get a project started from a template, which has been one of Todoist's biggest issues in the past, because getting from template to ability. But you can also add a folder now. A folder is a good way to organize specific projects. So in a way, I could say, these could be high level, and I could have that involved in a folder, and folders appear on this left hand side here, and you can pop them open, which is something that just keeps things a little bit more organized. Aside from that, there are some additional abilities, like the ability to invite members. Up here in the right hand corner, you can change a few things as well, like change the company logo, the company name, and also prohibit external guests as well, which is really good. You can also set up when you have an email domain connected, that might be like keepproductive.com, a way for you to have project discovery, which means that all the availability of the teams appear here. So how does a project look, and what's sort of different with it? So for example, if I go into the layout area, I can see it as a list, a board, and a calendar. And a lot of things have changed in the Todoist sorting and filtering areas. For example, now I can group by priority, but I can also group that in a board, and I can sort it by the due date, even though there's no due date, it's associated here. And I can even filter down using these abilities. I can have completed tasks on, but largely this has completely changed in the last couple of months in terms of what it looked like before. And there's also a brand new view, which is called calendar view. So you can also drag your items into the calendar and manage them here. And there's a lot of changes coming here. They've just introduced more filtering with due dates, priorities, and labels here as well. So that does make your experience much more enhanced. Now, overall, if you're looking at something like team workspaces, you probably need to be a relatively small team. I'd probably say this wouldn't be fantastic for over 25, maybe 50 people, just because I think list-based management of your tasks might not be suitable for that. But at the same time, it really depends on how your company works and what you do as a company as well. But this is actually quite a nice system, because it really separates some of the work from, for example, your personal areas, which are now titled My Projects, which is much nicer, and have a separate icon too, which helps that separation from work, which many people may have had with their Todoist account. Other things I noticed as well is if you add something into an inbox and you want to bring it into a workspace, you are prompted, you are bringing this into a workspace, and you can't bring stuff back into your inbox from a workspace account. So there are some limitations when it comes to that, but they're all also very intentional limitations as well. So I have a few tweets open here because I want to discuss some of the upcoming changes with Todoist. And one of the things that is definitely coming out is these team workspaces, with big calendar updates and also improvements to how they're doing stuff as sort of a general premise. They've got this new Todoist bulletin thing, which is pretty cool, and it sort of keeps you updated. I believe it's Stephen who runs the sort of the general premise of this in terms of getting it started. And you can also see updates and how the actual operations of the projects work in much detail. That's one thing I didn't touch on here. You can see that you can also do in the today area, grouping with workspaces and grouping with and filtering through workspaces. So that's a great way to just narrow things down too. Now, obviously Todoist, one of their biggest goals has been to focus a lot on the calendar aspects. Let me show you what that sort of looks like and what that's going to be hinting towards. And you can see here that this is Todoist calendar in the upcoming view. And it's going to be, I believe, connected with Google Calendar. So this is going to be a really big step for Todoist because, like I talk about a lot in my videos, they are going to be changing from a regular task management application to a daily planner app, which allows you to manage your tasks and your calendar in one. And that's a really big change for them because you can do things like time blocking. You could start managing your calendar, hopefully both ways, which is quite a big step forward, and really just be able to see things a lot more visually. And I think that's going to change a few things in the future. One of those is pricing. I do think Todoist is hideously underpriced. And once they add the calendar function, it's going to be even more underpriced. You get daily planner applications pricing between about $15 to $20 per month. And Todoist price at $5 per month now, and $6, I believe, for the business plan. So at the same time, I think that's going to rapidly change what Todoist is going to be priced at. I don't know anything about their pricing changes, but I just have a feeling that they're just grossly underpriced. $8 would still be a dramatic improvement on pricing. So that's just something to be aware of when looking at it. And I think they'll probably have a premium pricing or additional tier because it makes more sense where people don't necessarily have to jump up to that pricing if they don't want to. But I think a lot of people will be happy with it. Other things, I noticed that the labels and filters for calendar view rollout is naturally happening. That happened a few weeks ago. And Amir continues to post about how filtering is getting better in Todoist. Something I didn't notice is this 2 hours, 45 minutes. And that's something I've not seen. Maybe that's in the beta. That's a really nice feature that they have there. But largely, you can see there's a dramatic shift in Todoist syncing to be much more of a daily planner application. And that's really good news for a lot of people who are using Todoist and want a visual experience. So that was Workspaces. Let me know what you think about it. Will you be using it with you and your team? If you are a small team or maybe a big team, we've got lists that will help you to find the best tool for you if Todoist isn't meeting that scratch. So thank you very much. I look forward to seeing you in a future video and have a fantastic day ahead. Cheerio.